Hey, I'm here for a third match on the draw. This hand is pretty bad. If I knew that these bolts would be good, I could keep. This hand is so bad. Also, if these were delvers, I could keep, but I think that I'll just mulligan. This hand is pretty terrible. Nimble Mongoose needs some cantrips to get going, but hopefully I can draw those. Okay, Polluted Delta looks like we might be playing against a real deck. Underground Sea. Ponder. All reasonable. So I'm glad we didn't keep the hand with two bolts. And this hand at least has pressure and one daze. It's not ideal, but maybe it'll be good enough. I will begin the game with a Nimble Mongoose. Against these combo decks, pressure is key. You can have all the disruption you want in your hand, but you need pressure. These decks often play things like Cabal Therapy, so they can set up like a hand where they can beat any amount of disruption. All right, duress my daze, that's fine. I'll be able to wasteland next turn to disrupt my opponent, and maybe I'll ponder into additional disruption. I could also just use the wasteland to cast Tarmogoyf if I'm feeling brave. That would apply the most pressure and set up a sweet next turn. But I don't know if I can afford to do that. My opponent's five lands, five cards in hand. Okay, Lightning Bolt, one of the worst draws in the deck. Okay, I am going to ponder this turn. Hopefully hit a daze. Wow, daze, spell pierce, and ponder. I will elect to keep all these cards. Just need to figure out what order. All right, I'll put them in this order, drawing the daze immediately to make sure that I don't die. And then next turn, I can maybe ponder into a land. Next turn, I'll probably cast Nimble Mongoose. And the turn after that, ponder into a land and have Spell Pierce up. That sounds good to me. Okay, my opponent end of turn Brainstorm is definitely not going to counter that. I'm glad to have a counter off the Gemstone Mine. Okay, my opponent cast another Brainstorm, but after playing a land. Chrome Monk's definitely fine with me. Reduces the total number of cards in my opponent's hand. Okay, my opponent imprinted an Infernal Tutor. Okay, here's a Lotus Petal, that's fine. Black, black, for Cabal Ritual. How many cards in graveyard does my opponent have? Six. Maybe my opponent should have activated the Lotus Petal first. I don't think Cabal Ritual counts itself. I don't know. If it does, I would like to daze right now to make my opponent use blue. But if it doesn't, then that would just give my opponent a threshold. Okay, I did a quick Google, and it says that my opponent will get 3 black mana, which is fine with me. Alright, my opponent probably should have used the Lotus Petal first. Okay, I got red. Empty the Warrens. Oh my god. That's absurd. Oh my god. Even if I dazed the Cabal Ritual. Oh, if I had dazed the Cabal Ritual, I would have won. Oh. Yeah, I had not considered Empty the Warrens. Alright, well, I should daze one of the copies. Okay, so my opponent has 8/1s. I need to get Goyf into play. There's another tropical. Oh man, it's kind of tough playing against Storm deck. Okay, trade. Okay, right now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cards in my graveyard. So the Nimble Mongoose will be thresholded. And I don't really want to draw the Spell Pierce next turn, so I'm going to ponder. Shuffle this, and then cast the Nimble Mongoose. Okay, so I block this turn, go down to 7. Next turn, cast Goyf. Block, go down to 3. And then I'm not gonna die if my opponent doesn't have anything else for the rest of the game. Gataxian Probe. Pay the blue mana. What the hell? My opponent has a Tendrils? That's so messed up. If I would have just used the Wasteland this turn. Alright, whatever. So if I block two creatures, I go to 3. Alright, well, if my opponent draws a free spell or a ritual, my opponent will win. Also, if my opponent just Tendrils me, oh, maybe I should have just cast the Goyf and used a Wasteland. But this game has been pretty ridiculous. Okay, great. My opponent didn't Tendrils me, so now I actually have a chance of winning. Let's wasteland this Underground Sea. And cast a Delver. And I still can't quite attack. But once I do attack, I'll be able to kill my opponent very quickly. Okay, my opponent has 2 fetch lands. Alright, my opponent's just gonna bash with everything. Gonna block, block. And maybe I should just trade the Delver. I don't really want to go to 1. It turns off all my fetch lands. Okay, so now I'm at 2. And I can maybe race my opponent. I attack for 8. Okay, having two stifles is actually great. I can stifle both my opponent's deltas. I'll just attack with a Goyf this turn. I may as well attack with both, and then next turn, if I want to, I can hold back one Mongoose. But now my opponent can't fetch, otherwise my opponent will lose the game. Just to damage. Alright, I'm gonna stifle that. If my opponent has a Dark Ritual, I also can't win, but at this point, I'm just assuming the best possible for me. Also going to stifle that. Alright, well, I could win if my opponent has nothing. Okay, ponder. I like that. I draw a fetch land, I can just bolt the goblin and attack for exactly 8. No, Dark Ritual. Alright, well, I still played good, I think. Okay, for this matchup, I have Ancient Grudge, Red Elemental Blast, and Spell Pierce. And then, I don't know about the rest, probably Destructive Revelry. I can board out two Tarmogoyfs because you really don't need that many threats, you just need one most of the time. And then after that, I can board out Forked Bolt and two Lightning Bolts.